गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस आइडियल सॉल्यूशन। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय आइडियल सॉल्यूशन? आइडियल सॉल्यूशन दी सॉल्यूशन विच ओबे रॉल्स लॉ ओवर द इंटायर रेंज ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन आर नोन एज आइडियल सॉल्यूशन। डैट मीन्स इफ दे आर टू कंपोनेंट एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइक डैट बेंजीन एंड टोल्यूइन आर मिक्स टूगेदर then it forms ideal solution. It obey Rawls law. As for example, suppose that benzene is A component and toluene is B component, then it follows Rawls law. According to Rawls law, vapor pressure of solution is equal to vapor pressure of component A plus vapor pressure of solvent B. We consider here is benzene and B as a toluene, then vapor pressure of solution becomes P naught A xA. This P A, yani vapor pressure of benzene, is converted into this component P naught A xA according to Rawls law. PB similarly becomes P naught B xB. So if the solution which obey Rawls law, this equation is followed by the solution, then that solution is known as ideal solution. Its example is substances having similar structure and polarity form ideal solution. That means benzene and toluene having the same structure, almost same structure, and polarity is also same, both are non-polar. So it is said to be ideal solution. Similar other example in N hexane plus N heptane. These is also ideal solution example. These are the few examples of ideal solution. Next important point of it is characteristics of ideal solution. Characteristics, first characteristics is let A and B two component of the ideal solution. Suppose we take 100 ml of A, 100 ml of B. Then before mixing, the volume of A and B, total volume of A and B is 200 ml. When we mix together and it form ideal solution, then its volume also is same, that is 200 ml. That means before mixing volume is 200 ml and after mixing the volume is also 200 ml. That means the change in volume is zero. Delta V mixing should be zero. The first characteristic is if delta V mixing is zero, then that is said to be ideal solution. Similarly, delta H mixing, yani before mixing, the temperature of A and B are same. After mixing, the temperature is also same. Then that means there is no enthalpy in change. That means delta H mixing is zero. That means this process is neither exothermic nor endothermic. You earlier read it, delta H negative. If the value of delta H is negative, that means it is exothermic reaction. If delta H is positive, then that means it is endothermic reaction. But in ideal solution, delta H mixing should be zero. Third important characteristics is AA interaction. Suppose a solvent A is the interaction between AA and the interaction between B and B is same when after mixing A and B. AB interaction should be equal to or almost equal to A interaction and BB interaction, then it said to be ideal solution. That means there are three main characteristics of ideal solution. Delta V mixing should be zero, delta H mixing should be zero, and the interaction between AA and BB is equal to interaction between AB. So we follow this graph. Y axis we draw vapor pressure, Vp means vapor pressure, and along X axis mole fraction is drawn. In y-axis, this xA is 1. xA 1 means mole fraction of component A is 1. If A, the mole fraction of A is 1, then obviously the mole fraction of B at this point should be 0. As we move towards x-axis, the mole fraction slowly decreases and it becomes to 0. Similarly, the mole fraction of B is initially 0, and on increasing along x-axis, it becomes to mole fraction 1. So on x-axis, mole fraction of A and B are mentioned, and on y-axis, vapor pressure is mentioned. We take care about, this is the equation for ideal solution, where in this equation, if xA is this point, xA is mole fraction is 1, and keeping xB value 0, here mole fraction is 0, to keep here value 0, then this term becomes 0, this is 1, then total vapor pressure of solution becomes P naught A. That means, is this axis only vapor pressure of A, pure solvent A is shown. As mole fraction of A decreases, the vapor pressure of A in ideal solution decreases. And it becomes zero here because mole fraction of A becomes zero. Similarly, you see here as the mole fraction of here xB is 0, so vapor pressure of B is, vapor pressure pure solvent B is here 0. As mole fraction increases, the vapor pressure of B also increases. At this point, this y-axis, only vapor pressure of pure solvent B is shown. Why? Because mole fraction of B at this axis is 1. At this point, mole fraction of B is 1. You keep the value xB here, 1. And xA at this point is 0. Then the whole term becomes 0. And now vapor pressure of solution becomes P naught B. Where P naught B is mentioned in this y-axis. Here P naught B and this is P naught A. Here you can see the value of P naught is lesser in comparison to the value of P naught B. But this curve is represent vapor pressure of solvent, vapor pressure of component A in ideal solution. This curve is represent as vapor pressure of B in ideal solution. And this curve represent the total vapor pressure of solution in which two components are mixed together, A and B. So this is very important topic, ideal solution and its characteristic. In board exam, one question to be asked, ki write what do you mean by ideal solution and write it two characteristics of ideal solution. Okay, thank you.